like a wife or a son, but comfort can be felt in the knowledge that they are now both in heaven. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed through the grace of God rest in peace.
U.S. Marshals!
Where is she?
Burying my wife and child.
Where's my partner?
Your men didn't cover the tracks, Pablo. We know it was you.
Then prove it.
Come here!
Not this way.
Jimmy, I didn't know you were married. Good to know.
You better let her go, or you're a dead
man. I'm already dead.
This is a harassment. Stay away from my client.
You again? Jimmy, let's go. We warned him.
It's your one warning. What?
One warning.
Get him out of here! Get him out of here!
Where do you come off asking the judge to deny my client bail? Give me one good reason.
I'll give you two. Premeditated murder and the woman is a flight risk. Coroner reports her husband was killed with a blow to the back of his head from a kayak oar. Do the math.
It's all circumstantial.
Plus, motive. Christy killed him while he was out on appeal. She picked the perfect time.
What are you talking about?
If a verdict was upheld, his estate would go to the government. Christy would get nothing. But if he died while he was appealing, as is the case, then his conviction is automatically vacated.
And Christy keeps every penny.
I have the authority to offer a plea. Second degree murder. The offer goes away if this thing goes to trial.
Isn't it true you believed your husband would lose his appeal, so you killed him for his money, then planned to flee the country?
Objection! Conjecture! He's just making crap up.
Mr. Montez, are you making crap up?
Allow me to submit Exhibit B. My office secured a subpoena to search a storage unit owned by Ms. Talbot, and this is what we found. A fraudulent passport, Christie's picture, a new name, a new birth date. According to this, her name is Laura Willis, and her age is 43. So no, I'm not making crap up.
I, if it wasn't him, we'll find out who did it.
But before that, somebody's got to settle up for the hit on Hazel Ortega.
Put the guns down and your hands up.
You're crazy!
You have the gun pointed at the wrong guy, Rick.
Yo, what you talking about?
Luther, tell him. Tell him he's next.
You hear this, cop? Trying to play mind games?
This is none of your concern, detective.
We found your prints behind the stove at the restaurant, Luther.
What? What's he trying to say, Luther? Huh? You killed Pedro and Lisa?
There was a time when crimes against the people in the neighborhood were not allowed.
You still preaching that neighborhood garbage? You were gonna kill me for that? I'm your brother.
Then let's put our guns down and talk about it.
Nah. Later for that.